Oh, are you kidding me?
It's raining.
Oh, it's like really raining.
Holy moly, it's raining. I'm getting wet.
It just got through us.
Oh, God.
It's just coming on us.
All right.
Nothing will make this better than the rain for his first time driving an RV.
That's not good.
Of course, right when we're ready to leave, it starts pouring down rain. The campground is like 3 hours away, and I don't think either one of us feels comfortable driving in this.
All right, are we ready?
I'm already claustrophobic.
The construction crew is gonna be here any minute to start tearing apart the stairs, so we can't really go back in the house. So I guess we're just gonna have to ride out this rain in here until it lets up.
Yeah, if it lets up.
I want
sit at the table, though. Move so I can get out of here.
I want it.
Whine a little harder.
What are your nice words? Okay. Ava, do you want these? There's these Cheetos.
I'm ready if we can go.
Riley, pick a kind. This is what's in here.
Look,
which ones
you
do
see?
You want? Okay, then don't have anything. I'm just gonna leave everybody here, and Mommy and Daddy are gonna go without y'all, okay? I don't mean to get frustrated about all this, but the whole purpose of an RV trip is to actually go somewhere, and now we're all cooped up in here. And if this is what the whole trip's gonna be like, we may have made a mistake. Okay, nope.
I guess we're gonna have to stay in here forever.
All right, everybody has pottied. Everybody is good to go.
Hopefully the rain lets up a little bit.
It stopped right now, so let's go. Thankfully, the rain has let up, and so have the girls' attitudes. I mean, that's gonna be our biggest kind of like uncertainty on this trip is how are they all going to act? Because we're basically gonna be living on top of each other for the next few nights.
Let's call Uncle Doofus.
You wanna talk to Uncle Doofus?
Hello.
What's
Hello.
Up? Well, we're about to hit the
Hi,
road.
Uncle Doofus.
That's not my name.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, you're bullies.
We got two RVs loaded up.
Dude, we're gonna miss you, man.
I know, dude, it sucks, man. I got another test done. I just don't know when I'm gonna get results back. I don't know if it's gonna be a day, 2 days, 3 days. I don't know. I mean, they've been kind of sporadic on the results.
Yeah.
My work protocol is I gotta have two negative tests before I can return to work. And so I want the same thing for being in front of my family. I'd want the same kind of protocol I'm doing for them to make sure that I do have two negative tests, and then I'm not gonna put anybody in danger of getting sick.
I don't know, we'll see, man. Let us know when y'all make it.
All right. Everybody say bye.
Bye-bye.
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 Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
We miss you. Everybody's gotta cross their fingers.
See you later.
Later, bro.
Bye.
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 All right, let's hit the road.
Y'all ready for this? You nervous?
I've only driven this all of about 5 miles total.
Dude, wide turns.
Maybe I need to go ride with Ashley and Nick.
I would.
Just stay in one lane, that's the trip.
Listen to Blake, I would.
The whole time, we're not gonna be running around on anything. We stay on our bottoms, just like we do in the car. If you need to get up, let's make sure we know what you're doing and not running around, okay? Because Daddy's gonna be driving, Mommy's gonna be throwing up.
No, I thought I had autopilot. This trip is like trial by fire because for the first time, you're driving this massive home down the road, and you have your entire family in the back.
Don't drive your daddy crazy, all right?
Because then he'll drive crazy.
Good luck, Buzz.
Riley, and I don't want to hear you ask 20,000 times, are we there yet?
3.5 hours.
Your daddy's passing Uncle Nick up, and we swaying along back here.
I don't know
how people do this all the time. Oh, my gosh. Come on.
Sit.
Where are you going?
Somewhere so you don't bust your face. This is why y'all need to be in car seats.
This is the worst place for them to be moving around
right
now.
I know. Can we wait till after the curves?
I mean, there is a chance that we could just be absolutely miserable with this. But this is something that we've been wanting to do for quite some time now, and the girls seem just the right age for it, and we gotta get out of the house. So I'm just gonna try to stay positive and have as much fun as we can.
Too bad Crystal and Dale can't come.
Yeah.
It sucks.
But sometimes it takes like 3 days to get those results, you know?
Yeah.
It's okay, you can take a nap, baby.
So what are the plans as far as the kitchen?
That stuff's ready to get painted. So while they're prepping to paint the kitchen, all that, he can start working on the stairs.
It's definitely challenging having a kitchen remodel happening during a pandemic. It is what we signed up for. We said we were gonna do this at this time of the year before the girls started kindergarten, but the stairs was like an unexpected thing.
They need to be built and painted while we're gone. Because once we're home, like, we have to be able to get upstairs. There's nowhere for them to sleep.
I just hope we don't come back from this trip and we're told that we have to leave again because they're either not done with the stairs or worse, they find something else wrong.
You should see it. Let's guess how many times Riley's gonna ask, are we there? 40 times.
I was gonna say 52.
I hope we get to find some pandas there.
Oh, I don't think we'll see pandas there.
Nope. Driving this RV is nothing like driving the Busbys. It is 3 times the size.
Oh my gosh, please remember we're not in a car.
Every crack in the road, it's like going over a ski jump. But yeah, I got this.
Huh?
Dad, are we almost there?
Yep, here we are.
Oh, slow down. Is this us?
It's Mystic Quarry.
This is where we're staying.
Hey, there's a pool. I've never been camping before.
Second. Oh, there's a teepees.
Oh, that's big. We're gonna sleep here for 3 days.
All right, now who knows what to do once we get here?
I'm gonna hook up at all the RV crap.
Welcome home.
Hey, Dad.
We going camping, Hazel.
How did she get up there?
There's so much to do here. There's a pool, there's a lake close by for swimming and a river to float down. But the plan tonight is just to set up camp, relax, and let the adventure start tomorrow.
Someone else just came out of there on my hands.
You needed that clear piece.
Try it.
Welcome to the show.
Like this.
Gross.
There.
Don't you dare. Adam Busby. Don't. That's disgusting.
Setting up an RV is a little bit more work than I thought.
I mean, it probably could have helped to look through the RV handbook, but ain't nobody got time to read that thing.
Hot potato, who has the hot potato? If you have the hot potato, you are out. Oh, no, Ava, you're out. What is that?
Oh, no, the camper's peeing like a horse.
Where is it coming from?
It has to go to the bathroom, Brad.
Gross, gross, gross.
What is it?
I don't know, but I hope it's not peeing.
It's just gushing out.
Is it supposed to drain through something?
Y'all move away from it. If that's pee water, I don't know.
It's pee.
Turn that switch off.
There.
Yeah, it's off now.
It's fixed.
This is what you call city coming camping, when nobody knows anything about anything.
What happened to this bathroom?
It stinks.
What's the smell in there?
Hazel, what did your booty do?
Did you fart in there?
No.
What is that smell?
I'm checking.
Don't open it.
I want the toilet.
How would you stick your face in a toilet?
We can't sleep with that smell.
Ew.
For real now. What are you going to do about that?
It's just poop water.
We're one night in, and this whole place already smells like a porta potty.
Some cologne or something you can spray in here?
We need to figure this RV life out and figure it out fast.
Hey, well, this is RV life. Smells every now and then.